So the price you would pay for something represents the subjective value you hold for that item, whether it's a dinner, a smartphone, or a vacation. To people who study decision-making, this value information is a central element of the decision process. It's what allows you to compare different options and make a selection. Now, this holds for all kinds of choices, whether it's choosing to buy a laptop or keep your cash, choosing between different career paths, or even choosing a spouse. Traditional theories of rational choice, which describe how an ideal chooser should behave, assume that value is absolute and not relative. This means that the value hold for an item is determined only by the properties of that item and doesn't depend on what you're comparing it to or things you've seen in the recent past. However, a fundamental finding in psychology and neuroscience is that the brain handles information in a relative, not absolute manner. For example, a gray square will look lighter on a black background and darker on a white background. They're the same kinds of processes that operate in the brain areas handling sensory information from the external world may also operate in the brain areas that handle internal value information and that drive decision making. We found, for example, that people will pay more for an item if they were recently in a poor environment, seeing only low value objects. Conversely, people will pay less for the same exact item if they were in a recently rich environment. Interestingly, this behavior is mediated by the same neural computations and processes that mediate similar effects in perceptual brain areas, suggesting that comparative processing is a fundamental feature of how the brain handles information. Taken as a whole, this means that truly no man is an island. Even the values we place on things depend on a fundamental way on the world around us.